Hello children, how are you all? I'm Amrita Kar, back here to conduct today's EVS class. In last EVS class, you have learnt about road and rail transport. You have seen, you have come to know about the vehicles which run on road and which need tracks to run. And at the same time, I hope you all are aware about the rules and regulations also little bit. Like whenever you are riding a two-wheeler, you have to wear helmet. Whenever you are driving a car, in that case, you need to wear the seat belts. And while in a moving bus, you should not put your hands out. We all know all these things. And I am sure that you are good children, so you are going to follow these. In today's class, we are going to learn about water transport. Water transport is a type of transport which helps us to travel through water from one place to the other. It is the oldest means of transport and it is very cheap also in comparison to air transport or road transport. But you know, water transport takes little longer time than other kind of transport. Different types of water transport are ship, boat, steamer. Some water transport move underneath water also, like submarine. Now we will learn about water transport. What can we see here? We can see a boat. A boat is rowed. There is no such machine attached to it. Can you see this wooden stick which is kept in slanting way? So this is known as oar. So we have to move the oars to row the boat. Boats are usually made up of wood, but they can't go in the deep sea. Which water transport can you see here? You can see a ship here. From the picture itself, you can understand a ship is big in size and it can accommodate many people. It can carry goods from one place to the other, which are located far off. Not only that, it can go even in the mid-sea. It can carry things from one country to the other, as well as it can sail through the oceans. Do you know who sails a ship? A sailor sails a ship and we call a sailor as captain. Huge ships are known as crews. They have many facilities like swimming pool or table tennis court or gaming zone. People usually take a tour in crews. Here comes a yacht. Here comes a yacht. Usually, yachts move with the help of wind. Can you see these white pieces? They are the pieces of cloth, usually. It can be made up of plastic also, not only cloth or any other material. What happens when the air moves from one side to the other? With the help of that, this yacht also moves from one place to the other. Look at this water transport. This is known as steamer. Steamer is much smaller than the ship, but bigger than a boat. Especially fishermen, when they go out for fishing in the middle of the sea, they take this steamer along with them. Now, you can ask me why it is known as steamer. Okay, look at the picture. Can you see some smoke is coming out of a pipe? So, steamers actually move with the help of the energy generated by burning something. That's why this smoke comes out. And that's why it is known as steamer. Some kind of steam is created and with its pressure, the steamer moves from one place to the other.
Look at the screen. What can you see? Something gray in color. How does it look like? As if something is coming out of the sea. It looks like a pipe, right? And look at the pipe. At the edge, it seems something clear is there. Let's see, which water transport are we talking about? This is a submarine. So submarines move underneath water, and the pipe which we were seeing in the beginning, through that the people who are there inside the submarine can see the things which are moving on the sea, and accordingly they can control the movement of the submarine. Submarines are used by security forces. It is also used by Indian Navy. Here comes a water scooter. Water scooter is also a mode of water transport, but usually people ride on water scooter for fun. This water scooter, they can carry one or two people together at the most, not more than that. And people usually ride on water scooter to have fun in the sea.
So, what all we have learnt in today's class? We have learnt about water transport. Along with this video, today you will get to see a worksheet also, which will enable you to write about road transport, rail transport and water transport in your environmental science notebook. Thank you for watching this video. Bye bye. See you.